What's going on, guys? Andy here, and in this video we are going to do something special. We will solve a hard interview question from LeetCode, which is commonly asked at top companies like Amazon, Bloomberg, Facebook and Google, and it is called Burst Balloons. Now, this challenge is going to use a special dynamic programming approach, which I'm sure you really love. It is called the mixed dynamic programming. So stick with me until the end of the video and make sure you check out our giveaway, because I will have a one-on-one Skype session with one lucky winner. So all you have to do is going to be at the end of the video. See you there and let's solve the problem.
We seen man last night, they froze. Was no cameras, was no pose. Just like that one time at Cello. Good thing man weren't pulling out phones.
Burst balloons. Given n balloons indexed from 0 to n minus 1, each balloon is painted with a number on it represented by a ray nums. You are asked to burst all the balloons. If you burst the balloon I, that's a type right there, you will get nums left, crossed nums I, crossed nums right coins. Here left and right are adjacent indices of I, right? So initially, the adjacent indices of I are I minus 1 and I plus 1, but after we burst some balloons, they could be different than that. After the burst, the left and the right then becomes adjacent, naturally. Find the maximum coins you can collect by bursting the balloons wisely. You may imagine nums of minus 1 equals nums of n equals 1, right? So if we burst the first balloon, obviously we won't have a left balloon, right? So we are going to obtain nums 1 cross nums right. That's why nums minus 1 is 1. So n less or equal than 500, nums of I less or equal than 100, that's perfect. And you might need some time, I recommend you pause this video and go through the input 3158 and explain yourself why the output is 167, alright? Because we are going now straight into the solution. Alright guys, we start by identifying what kind of problem is this. And this is an optimization problem because it asks you to find the minimum or the maximum cost of doing something, and they define the cost in their own way. So, this kind of problems, the optimization problems, are solved in two possible manners: greedily or by a dynamic programming approach. And I recommend you to pause the video now and think about some greedy approach. Alright, if you have thought enough of it, you've probably noticed that there is no suitable greedy approach here. And one more hint that is going to tell you that is the size of n, right? Because when we usually solve problems greedily, we just sort the input in some way and then it works smoothly. So the time complexity is big O of n log n, so n could have been greater than 500, something like, let's say, 100,000, right? But because n is 500, we are going to have a solution here in big O of n cube. N is going to be a dynamic programming one. And if you even have solved some problems similar with this one, you will notice furthermore that this is a mixed dynamic programming approach. But if you haven't, that's totally cool. We will find out right now what this means. Now, when we usually solve dynamic programming problems, we break the bigger problem into smaller ones, solve those problems, and then combine them together to get the answer for the bigger one. Here, because this is a mixed dynamic programming problem, the bigger problem is the whole range of balloons, and the smaller problems are little ranges of balloons. So, our DP is going to sound like this. DP of left and right is going to be the maximum coins you get for bursting, right, all the balloons from the left one to the right one, right? So let's comment this. And this is our DP, right? So we want to burst all the balloons from the position left to the position right without caring about bursting all the other balloons and getting maximum coins for that. Perfect. Now, if we manage to compute this dynamic programming, we know that our answer is going to be DP of 1 and n. Now, we have to think about the recurrence relation. And 99% of the times for this kind of problems, the recurrence relation consists of another for loop in which we fix an intermediate point. So for computing our DP of left and right, we will need to fix some intermediate position, and let's call this P, right? We will fix some P between left and right, and we have to give this P some meaning. And our meaning here is going to be P is the last balloon that we are going to burst in the range from the left to the right, right? So the last balloon to burst. Now, do we know what is the answer for DP of left and right knowing the P? And we definitely do, because P is the last balloon we are going to burst. So before bursting P, we are bursting all the balloons from position left to position P minus 1. bursting all the balloons from position P plus 1 to position right. Now, we don't necessarily know the exact order in which we burst these balloons, right? We can first burst the balloon right, then burst the balloon left, then burst the balloon right minus 3, left plus 3, and so on. But all we know for sure is that these two subproblems, left P minus 1 and P plus 1 right, are independent of each other. So, dp of left and right is going to be equal to dp of left and P minus 1 plus dp of P plus 1 and right plus the final cost, which is the number of coins that we get for bursting the P balloon. And what is that? Do we know what is this cost? And we surely do, because it's going to be nums of P crossed. What is going to be the balloon on the left of this P balloon? It's going to be now left minus 1, right? Because we've burst all the balloons from left to right, but P, so we remain here with the balloon left minus 1, which is intact, and the balloon right plus 1, which is intact too, right? So it's going to be nums of left minus 1 crossed nums of right plus 1. And this is the cost, guys. For some P, this is the cost of bursting all the balloons from left to right, and P being the last balloon burst. We are going to fix all these possible P's from left to right, and take, as you guessed, the maximum between all these expressions, and this is going to be our dp of left and right. In the end, we return dp of 1 and n, and our problem is solved. What is the time complexity? Big O of n cubed. Because we have two nested for loops for the left and the right, and for computing this dp state, we have another for loop for the p. Big O of n cubed, guys, now it's time to write the code for it. We initially have this vector of integer nums. Now, as I don't want to worry about positions minus 1 or n, I will build myself another vector, which will consist of value 1 in the beginning, all these values from the vector nums, and value 1 in the end. So, first of all, let's take the number of balloons, which is n equals nums.size. And after knowing this, remember the corner case. If this is equal to 0, let's return 0 just to be safe about it. And let's build our vector now. So, vector of integers, let's call it balloons, right? So, the short for balloons, and initially it's going to have one value equal to 1. Then I will take each value in the vector of nums, so int num in nums, and I will have balloons dot push back of num, right? And after that, in the end, I will have again another one, so balloons dot push back of 1. Perfect. Now I need to define my dp vector, so I will have a vector, right, of integers, which is going to be called dp, and it will consist of n plus 1 vector of integers, right, of size n plus 1, and let's say they are all initially equal to 0. So this is how you construct a two-dimensional vector in the STL library. And let's think a little bit about the order in which we will compute our dp. When we are going to find the value for dp of left and right, we are going to need the values for some dp of a greater left, or maybe the same left but smaller right. So the right order in which we should compute these values is with the left starting at position n this time, and as long as is greater or equal than 1, left minus minus. For this left, I will have another for loop for the right, and the right obviously will start now from the left position, as long as is less or equal than n, and right plus plus. And now I have two possible cases. The first one, I like to be safe about this kind of cases, is when left is equal to the right. So let's take it separately. If left is equal to right, what is going to be my dp of left and right? Is going to be, I will just burst the left balloon. So this is balloons of left minus 1 crossed balloons of left, crossed balloons of left plus 1. As simple as that. Now, if those two are different, we are going to have here three possible cases. The first one is when P, our balloon that we said we are going to burst the last, is equal to the left, right? So P equals left. We want to burst the left balloon, the last one, right? So for this, dp of left and right, we can initialize this to, well, dp of left plus 1 and right, because we will first burst those balloons, plus when bursting the left balloon, we will have balloons of left minus 1 crossed balloons, balloons of left, crossed balloons of right plus one. Perfect. Now, the second one is when P is going to be equal to the right. So P equals right, very similar to this one, but in this case, we will have dP of left and right is equal to the maximum between the above value. So what we already have here in dP of left and right, and we will burst the right balloon the last, right? So dP of left and right minus one plus, when bursting that balloon, I will have balloons of left minus one crossed balloons of right. So right crossed balloons of right plus one, right? And this is the second case. Now, for the first case, we will have left less than P, which is less than right. So here we will need a for loop, right? So we will go with P from left plus one, as long as P is less than right and P plus plus. And what is the formula for dP of left and right? Well, dP of left and right is again going to be the maximum between what it is already here, so dP of left and right, and what is the value for this P? It's going to be dP of left and P minus 1 plus dP of P plus 1 and right. Again, we don't know the specific order, but we don't care. They are independent. Plus, when bursting the P balloon, we will have balloons of P crossed balloons of left minus 1 crossed balloons of right plus 1, right? And this is it. Now, in the end, when we will finish to execute these two nested for loops, we shall know the answer. So we shall return dP of 1 and n. And let's see if this works. Let's run the code for it. Fingers crossed. All right, looks like it works. Let's submit the code for it. Fingers crossed. Let's see how we do. And it is a success. Faster than 59%. It's pretty good. You can optimize this code in a lot of ways. But for now, this is all, guys. All right, guys, we have solved the burst balloons technical interview question, super often asked at firms like Amazon, Google, and Facebook. And now for my special giveaway, I am going to have a one-on-one call on Skype on whatever topic that you like, and you can be that lucky winner. You just have to write in the comments your favorite dynamic programming problem on LeetCode and share this video on Facebook. I will randomly choose you and we will have that Skype call on whatever it's on our mind or whatever your topic that you have to improve on. All right, guys, now as always, if you find this content valuable, make sure to support the channel. So hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, and I can't wait to see you on the next one. Bye. I never touch your man is a goofy and he could get brushed. I can't name a rapper or a girl that I trust. I dream about turning these youths into dust. Hey.